to this point, just what do you think about how the offensive line as a whole has played through 2 weeks of spring?
I think one thing we figured out is that we have a good offensive line room and we're deep. We have a lot of competition going on, just competing every day with a lot of depth.
How helpful do you feel like it is for you guys that you're back, Truss is back, that you've got Seth in the middle, that you got those guys that y'all have all worked together and they're coming back?
Oh, I think it's big. I think we have a couple guys that have been through it, know what to do, can really help the young guys come along and kind of take people under their wing and kind of show them the way.
What does Austin Blaski bring to this team, especially just all the experience he's got at this point?
A lot of toughness. He's one tough kid. Effort. There's not a day that he's not giving his all for everybody out there. Like I just said, everybody got a lot of respect for him, and he brings it every day.
How did you see Ernest approach last fall and then not being able to play, being out? Where do you think he's gotten better since he's been on the bench?
I think Ernest kind of took to me with that a lot after I was hurt and didn't get to play. I kind of just told him, stay in the film room, just don't let your football knowledge go to waste. Just try to learn as much as you can in this time, and I think it's showing right now that he did.
What have you learned from playing with Coach Searles over a year, and how much more comfortable are you this year sort of understanding what he's expecting?
Definitely a lot more. He's always done a good job being clear of what he wants. But he comes every day, coaches you just as he'd coach anybody, and I've got a lot of respect for him.
When you talk about that depth and what that's something that you've learned this spring, who are some of the guys that we may not think of but that have impressed you?
Michael Morris, Dylan Fairchild are both really impressive right now. Jared Wilson, he's an athlete, he's physical, he's smart. And there's a lot. Monroe came in, he's athletic, and he just shows how athletic he is. Of course, he's got things to learn here and there just about college ball, but a lot of people have came in and started doing really well.
Seems like Josh Miller might be a little bit limited in just what he's been able to do. What are your early impressions of him?
He's also really athletic. He goes out there, he's doing non-contact right now, so just kind of going through drills. But he's done really good. He's kind of been picking it up in the meeting room, just picking up on things.
How much y'all rotated guys in and out throughout all of last year? Like, is there less pressure to figure out, hey, these five guys are going to be our starters, knowing, hey, this is something that could go throughout the entirety of the season anyway?
I think one of Coach Searles' goals is to find a starting five and then find a backup group that there's not much drop-off. And I think right now we do a lot where everybody gets a lot of reps, so there's no telling. There's people are getting a lot of reps every practice.
What have you seen out of Amarius this spring, especially knowing that he's going to be a guy who's stepping into a much bigger role with Robert and Warren moving on?
A lot. He's gotten very mature with how he goes about things, just coming into practice, not really taking plays off and things like that, just going out there and grinding every day, just really stepping into the shoes that he's got to fill.
We had a chance last week to talk to Kendall. What have you seen from him as he gets ready for this year?
He's definitely stepped into more of a leader role on our team. He does a really good job of just picking guys up when they have bad plays, or you know, just getting people on the right page, just trying to get everybody going.
I understand that you were pretty close to Devin Willett. In what ways are you guys honoring him or trying to honor him in the spring?
It's something that'll never leave our minds. It was one of our brothers, one of our best friends. Got a picture of him in the offensive line room now. Got this on my wrist for him. But yeah, it's just something that will always just come about. Even when we're watching plays, all the plays come up and it's just, you see them there. So it's just, we always know he's there with us and taking care of us.
How big have your teammates been, and really you guys in the offensive line room, in trying to, you know, carry forward after that?
We've always been a really close group, just hanging out all the time, just even out of football, even in football. There's never really any arguments. But I would definitely say this has brought us closer together as a whole. And I think you can really tell out of practice and just in general life.
Well, you guys have split a lot of time, you know, taking reps at right guard in particular. Who is kind of doing that now with you?
Micah and Dylan both take some reps there. It's really just Coach Searles mixes us in and out, getting us used to play to different guys because we rotate like you saw last year. So we got to get used to playing with different people.
Do you ever get tackle reps anymore? Or no? You tackle when you got here?
Here and there, just filling out.
What kind of adjustments have you had to make, if any, with Mike Bobo now calling the offense? How different is it from an offensive lineman's perspective?
I wouldn't say it's that much different. We kind of have a few nuances in our playbook that we're changing, tweaking things here and there, but nothing too big.
Do you sense like a new energy or focus, anything like that from Carson this spring, just from the opportunity he's got in front of him to win the starting job?
Definitely. I think Carson's definitely focused right now, fighting it out every day. He goes into practice with a good attitude and just there to win a job.
Any more questions? All right.
Thanks, Dave.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you.